give you an old tearjerker to get it out of the way.
Oh, Gary, you're right.
Good job.
Beautiful song.
Where's Kathy? Kathy, come up here, sweetheart, please. Come up here. Get your butt up here.
musical chairs for the next 20.
That's right.
I would like to introduce Reverend David Edwards. He's going to be offering our service this morning for Danny. Reverend, thank you so much for being here.
Sure.
Hi, sweetheart.
Mm-hmm. Like that song?
Yep.
Okay, so get that song.
Yeah.
I know.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
The eternal God is our dwelling place, and underneath are God's everlasting arms. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted. The Lord saves the crushed in spirit. The Lord heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. For great is our God, whose love and understanding is beyond anything that we can ever comprehend, but knowing that it is true love. To the family and extended family, I greet you in this day as we celebrate the life of Daniel Allen Holtman, affectionately known as Danny. We come together in grief, acknowledging our loss. But may God grant us grace that in pain we find comfort, in sorrow, hope, and even in this time of loss, the gift that is eternal life. Let us pray. Almighty God, from whom we come and to whom our spirits return, you're our refuge. You're our strength. You're a very present help in our lives. May you grant us your grace in this time of sorrow. Enable us to put our trust in you. May our spirits grow calm. May our hearts be comforted. May you lift our eyes beyond the shadows of this world to help us to see the light of eternity. You're the God of all that is seen and unseen. The mystery of death has stricken us, and behold our tears and sorrows. Yet through this mystery, may you send your miracles of smiles, of laughter, of joy. Help all who mourn find comfort in you. For we pray all of this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, for you are one God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
I'd like to share a reading with you. And it's from the book of Ecclesiastes, and it says, to everything and to everyone there is a season and a time and place for every purpose under heaven. There's a time to be born. There's a time to die. There's a time to plant. There's a time to harvest. There's a time of wounds and a time for healing. A time to tear down and a time to build up. A time to weep. And a time to laugh, a time to embrace, and a time to be apart, a time to gain, and a time to lose, a time to cherish silence, and a time to speak boldly, a time to remember, and a time to release, a time to bring to mind, and a time to hold. To everything and to everyone, there is a season and a time and place for every purpose under heaven. My next reading, it's Paul's letter, his first letter to the Corinthians. It's chapter 13. And it says, if I speak in the language both of humans and of angels, but do not have love, I'm nothing more than a noisy gong or a clashing cymbal. I have prophetic insight to understand all mysteries and all knowledge, but do not have love. I'm nothing, even with these gifts. If I hand over my physical body so as to boast, but do not have love, I've gained nothing at all. For I've come to see that love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious, boastful, arrogant. It's not rude. Love does not emphatically insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It doesn't cherish wrongdoing, but it rejoices when truth is spoken. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. Love hopes all things. Love endures all things. For I have come to see that love never ends. And so now, in this place, faith, hope, and love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. I would invite, I believe, Donna is going to play for us. I just want to share a few moments with you about what it means to love, what it means to unconditionally love. And so there is the love that we have for one another, the philos. There is a passionate love that we have, which is the eros love. And then there is the agape love, which is unconditional. No strings attached. Nothing in its way. Just a complete enfolding of love. When I was speaking to Gary earlier this week, I normally don't spend as much time as I do on my phone with someone I don't know.
We bonded.
And in some amazing way, I don't know, right through this iPhone, this agape love just creeped through and just kind of held me. Listen to stories about Danny. And one of the things that Gary was talking about is the scientific mind of Danny. And what really struck me was that Danny had this enfolding of agape love. It didn't matter who they were. It didn't matter where they came from. They didn't have to be a relative. They could be a relative. And people gravitated to ask Gary, to ask Danny, or Danny found out something and immediately started to research it. What's amazing about that is that's kind of the way God works. Doesn't care who you are, no matter what. And if you need help, I will send people to help you. And so the time kept ticking, and I apologize for calling late on my time frame, but I found out that Gary was 3 hours behind me, so it was the right time. Not me even knowing. And then a friend was bringing supper over, but we were still talking on the phone. I felt really bad. I don't know who it was, but I would like to express my sincere apologies for, you know, taking up too much of the time. But even after we were speaking and talking and about research and about art and about, I shared my stories of growing up in New York City and being a very young teenager and, you know, traveling down to Greenwich Village. But I lived uptown in Riverdale in the Bronx, and I would take the one train and we would talk about, you know, what Washington Square Park was like. 8th Street and 6th Avenue and St. Vincent, you know, things like St. Vincent's Hospital, all these things were coming up. And then we started talking about LGBTQIA communities. Before I even knew that, to have love for people when the world tells you you can't, that is wrong. It's not. It's the unconditional agape love that enfolds us. We talked about the AIDS quilt. What I didn't mention to Gary was that a relative of mine, their patch is on the quilt too. So when we hung up the phone, you know, Gary's not going to know this, but he'll know now. I had to sit in my chair just for a little while. And I cried. The world lost a precious gift that some people will cherish because they knew who Danny is. I was inspired after that phone conversation. My wife is actually, she said, honey, what's wrong? I said, I met this guy over the phone and he's amazing. And his husband is even more amazing. But I have to do this funeral for his husband. But I gotta tell you about him. And we sat there, and even in those moments, We knew that we were in the midst of a great gift. That someone gives more than themselves to something greater, to help fellow people without any strings attached. Jesus said this, "Don't let your hearts be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me, for in God's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, would I tell you that I go to prepare a place for you? When I go and prepare this place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, because where I am, you will be also." Thomas asked the question. He said, "Lord, we don't know where you're going. We don't know the way." Jesus smiled to him and said, "Thomas, I'm the way, I'm truth, and I am the life." When he spoke those words, because previously he told them that he and the Father were one, he and the Creator were one, just like we are one. And then he explained it further and said, "I'm the vine and you're the branches and we're connected." The connection, the community, the communion, if you will. It's not about the stuff that you see in a building that has a church name on it, because the building is just a building. But the community, the communication, the connection, the communion is us. The last thing, and this is specifically for you, I did look up in the book of Daniel, and it's chapter 10, verse 19. And this one was strongly weighed out among the others. And Gary, I think this can sum it up. It says, "O man greatly beloved, fear not. Peace will be with you. Be strong." Be strong, and when he spoke to me, I was strengthened. And I said, "Lord, speak, for you have strengthened me." It won't be like it was before. But as the days move on, as time moves on, you will remember your loved one. You will remember them in the rustling of the leaves, in the calm and rapid blowing of the fall wind. You'll remember Danny. When the snow touches the trees that have no leaves, these beautiful brown and white colors of winter comes, you'll remember Danny. When the change of seasons happen and we have the snow and the icicles and they start changing into the spring where the grass wakes up and the trees wake up, and we have a change of landscape, you'll remember. And then, of course, in the place where you are, which is 3 hours behind us in Arizona, the warmth of the sun while we're still in winter, the warm temperatures and the deserts and the landscaping of that, you'll remember that. Because now, the most important thing is that agape love is right there inside of you. every moment, every memory, every struggle, and every triumph is right there with you. And you will remember your loved one. So as long as we live, they live with us. Because all of us will remember our loved one. Let us pray. Caring God, consoling God, the one who we call for help. Strengthen us each and every day. For in times of sorrow, we turn to you. May you enfold us with your unconditional love. And may we conform to your never failing love in this life and the life to come. For you said that your Son is the resurrection and the life. And even though those whom we love die, you tell us, yet shall they live. And we who live and believe will never die. You said you were the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Your Son gave his life for us, and behold, he rose. And he is alive forevermore. For now, residing inside of us is you and your unconditional love. Amen.
Amen.
I believe now we're going to listen to a closing song. And we will do that at this moment. And once the song is finished, I will offer a blessing.
Get your tissues out, kids.
Perhaps love is like a misty mist, a shelter from the storm. It is to give you comfort, it is there to give you warmth. And in those times of trouble, when you are most alone, the memory of love will bring you home.
Perhaps love is like a window, perhaps an open door. It invites you to come closer. It wants to show you more. And even if you lose yourself and don't know what to do, the memory of love will see you through.
All of the soul is like a cloud, so strong as steel.
For some way of living, for some way to feel.
And sometimes love is home.
Love is like the ocean, full of conflict, full of pain.
receive this blessing. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you. May the Lord give you peace, the peace that surpasses all understanding. May it guard your hearts and minds in the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Mm-hmm. In the name of the one who created you, the one who redeemed you, and the one who sustained you, may you go in peace. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
How do you like the garden I built for Daddy?
Thank you so much, Pastor David.
Well, this concludes our funeral service this morning for Daniel. Again, on behalf of Gary, I would like to thank Reverend David for being here, for offering our service, and to all of you for being here, for your love and prayers and support, and to everybody at home, especially your sister Dawn, who couldn't be here with us today. At this time, I am going to ask, starting in the rear of the chapel, if you'd like to come forward, say final prayers, and then return to your cars. If you are riding in the limousine this morning, I'm going to be seating you in the family room just down the hall to the right here. It's going to take myself and the staff a few minutes. Of course, I want to give Gary a little extra time inside by himself for a little moment or two. And of course, we need to move flowers and get ready to go. So if you need to use the restroom, of course, once you exit here,